above all wonders the world has ever known. Above all wealth and treasures of the earth, there's no way to measure what you crucified, laid behind the stone. You lived to die, rejected and alone, like a rose trampled on the ground. You took the form and thought of me. Above all, above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man. Above all kingdoms, above all thrones, above all wonders the world has ever known. Above all wealth and treasures of the earth, there's no way to measure what you're worth. Laid behind the stone, you lived to die, rejected and alone, like a rose trampled on the ground. You took the form and thought of me. Laid behind the stone, you lived to die, rejected and alone, like a rose trampled on the ground. You took the form and thought of me. Amen. Hallelujah. Can you give your best clap to the Lord? Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. For our opening prayer this afternoon, I will call Brother Dennis to lead us our prayers. Hallelujah. Amen.
Shall we please bow our head for prayers? Oh, gracious Heavenly Father, once again we give you the thanks and glory. We thank you for this time. We thank you, Father, you brought us. We thank you for the first service, O Lord, Father. Once again, we are asking for your discernment once again, Lord. Come and sit in your throne, O Lord. Speak through your servant and guide and protect your lips, O Lord. Father, whatever that will come out of the lips, O Lord, be your word, O Lord. Father, we pray that, Lord, whatever that we will be doing here, Lord, will be the word that will glorify your name, O Lord. We pray that bless each and every one, O Lord. We pray commit all our dear brethren, O Lord, those on the live stream viewers, O Lord, Father, Lord. They are all in your hands, O Lord. Father, may this be a word to them, O Lord. The same blessing be received unto them, O Lord. We pray that, Lord, Father, protect each and every one, O Lord. Take care from the harms of this evil ways, O Lord, the time we are being, O Lord. Father, we are asking for your wisdom, understanding, and knowledge, O Lord. That, Father, we keep staying in this faith forevermore. At the end, we give all glory, honor, adoration. We thank you, Daddy. We bless you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Before we call our brothers here in our pulpit, can we sing one more song? Lord, I lift your name. Lord, I lift your name. Hallelujah. Amen.
I need thee every hour. Without Thee, we cannot do anything, O Lord. We need You, Lord, every hour, Lord. Without Thee, we cannot do anything, Lord. Every minute, a minute, we need You, Lord. Because we are living creature, Lord. Thou hast created us by Your word, Lord. Lord, Thou hast come in this world and sacrificed, and Thou hast given the own blood, Lord. Because in Thy blood we redeemed, Lord. Thank You, Jesus, Lord, for that blood, O Lord. Very precious blood, O Lord. We did not search You. We did not choose You, Lord. But Thou hast chosen us. Amen. Before the foundation of the world, Lord. We did not love You, but Thou hast loved us, Lord.
Amen.
Oh Lord, that price we cannot do You anything, Lord. Lord, once again we come in Thy presence, O Lord. Whatever in my mouth coming, Lord, behind the pulpit, angel of the Lord is standing, O Lord.
Amen.
O Lord, Thy presence is whole in this room, O Lord. Thank You for that, Lord.
Amen, Lord.
You are with us, and You are guiding us. You are teaching us, O Lord.
Amen.
We are not the teachers, O Lord. Only the Holy Spirit teaches, O Lord.
Amen.
Lord, I am nothing, O Lord. I don't have any words to say, Lord, but Thou can speak with us, Lord. Lord, You anoint me, O Lord. Anoint here each and every one, O Lord.
Amen.
So may we can understand, Amen. We can accept Thy word, O Lord. Lord, whatever the word comes, Lord, it is be true and spirit, O Lord. Lord, those who are on the live stream, oh Lord, bless each and every one, oh Lord. Those who are listening to the Holy Spirit, oh Lord, make them understanding whatever the word of God comes through here, Lord. And early morning we heard the message, oh Lord, it is the love of God, Lord. That love cannot change, oh Lord. The agape love, oh Lord, that manifests in our life, oh Lord. Oh Lord, be with us and guide us. We ask it in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Everybody is happy.
Amen.
In the house of the Lord.
Amen.
My subject is today onwards. We start, I think so. Conduct, order and doctrine of the church. So last week we decided to continue with the church order, the question and the answer also. So my subject is today is the Genesis chapter 1, 26 and 27. Genesis chapter 1:26 and 26:27. And God said, let us make a man in our own image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the fowls of the air and over the cattle and over all the earth and over every creeping things that creepeth upon earth. 27. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them.
Amen.
May God bless you all, and you may sit it. Today is the subject of question number 1. It is the Genesis chapter 1:26. The God created man, then formed him. God created him, then formed him. Formed means we can see the there is a form and create and make. There is a three things. Form, create, and make. It's similar to same thing, but it is the different the things. Form means bring together part or combine to create something. What says here? Bring together part or combine to create something. If we see the Genesis chapter 1, first verse, Genesis 1, yeah. In the beginning, God created the heaven and earth, and the earth was without form. The earth was without form. It was not formed, but and void and darkness was upon the face of the earth. It is shows us here. It was there, but with it says without form. Without form, it is not formed, like it is no shape. It is no shape. Nothing was there, and void. And darkness was upon the face of the earth. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. Because there was no formed anything. There is no cannot be seen. It was darkness, complete dark. You cannot see. So here says form means bring together part or combine to create something. Now God wants to create. Create means it should be. Create means bring something into existence. Bring something into existence means you can see visibly when he created things. Then here says the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the earth, of the deep, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the earth. Spirit of God means he is the light, same light. We cannot see that one. So he was moving upon the waters, and God said, let there be light. The spoken word, the creation, the God had a creation that the word, the creation, the he said spoken word, it is the it becomes. Amen. Through spoken word it already created. Amen. Means it already made. So Genesis 1:2, God created man, then formed. First he created man and then he formed. If you go to form means something was some form means something is there and we have to make it. We have to make it as a shape. We have to make a shape. So it is formed. So here says create shape. It can be on if technically things fabricator. Mm-hmm. Fabricator brother Nestor knows fabricator. So it was just one steel fixture is there, and you want to make a molding. Yes. And after that it will. You make a drawing, after the drawing you will make a shape. Which shape you need to make, you have that drawing. Without the drawing, you cannot do anything.
That's right.
Only you do like this, one material you take and you want to make. It without the plan, you cannot make anything. First you have to think about. Same like that only, God first, to man he wants to create. First he think about how to make a man.
That's right.
So he was before the foundation of the world, we were in his mind.
Amen.
So first he created man in his spirit. Because God is a spirit.
That's
we
right.
Can see here read Genesis chapter 2:28 also. 2:18. Yeah. 2:18. And the Lord God said, it is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him an helpmate for him. And Genesis chapter 2:7 also we can read. 2:7. And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. Because the God first he formed in a spirit man, then after he take the dust, and in that he formed. Formed means he bring the shape, and he give the breath into his nostril, the breath of life. The life came because the God created man. First he, in his own image he created the spirit. After that he formed in the dust also. So because we become a living soul. Now if you see the prophet is telling here, God created man male and female created man. Male and female. Now that's, I think, the is that first point. Now in Genesis 2:7, he says he are formed. Formed means underscore the first he created, he is got that underscore and he formed. Underscore, it is man out of the dust and breathed into his nostril and so forth. What is the difference or where is the connection in the above scripture? We can see in the above scripture means the 126. I mean, ask a question, pardon, and we want to read that first, that we got to wrote out of, if you want to follow it right back, it's right. But God created man, male and female, created him them. He created, because now he created man. Inside the man, he created male and female. Male and female together. So here formed out, or she one of the has God, Genesis 2:7, he formed man out of the dust of the earth. That's another place. I read them all, we can get them together here so you can see. Now the first place of this now said, we can see. Now, in this Genesis chapter 1:26, God made man his own image, and if you notice, we will get it so you can read it. And 26, if you'd like to read along with us, be glad for you to do, check me up. And God said, let us make man in our image after our likeness, and let them have dominion over fish of the sea. When we were same as he said here, the in our image after our likeness, after our likeness, he's telling here, see, let them have dominion over the fish of the earth, fish of the sea. Now we can see here, dominion means we are in this world. Now we have God before the foundation of the world. He make a man, he gave all the power to the man. The power, everything he gave that power. Now see, animals means he gave all the power. You come here, the power was with them. Amen. Adam and Eve, he made it. The power was with them. When they lost that dominion power, they make a mistake, they make a sin, and the dominion power, they lost it. Because what came, it is here, they disbelieve the word. So that's where that dominion power, they lost it. Here says, so God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Same God like he created. Male and female created them. Then here prophet is he's discussing, 71. I heard that discussed many times and around the world. Discussion come up on that. Now the Genesis chapters 2:7, which what he did here, all right, here it is. And God formed man out of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostril breath of life, and man became a living soul. What kind of formation? questioner wants to ask the question, what connection does this Genesis chapter 126 we have with the Genesis 2 and 7? God created two men, and which was the man, and what connection does that have? How does it connect up the scripture? Here question mark is there. Here says, well, if you notice close now, Genesis chapter 126, let us get the first part of God said, let us make man in our own image. Our course, we realize he taking to someone, he was speaking to another being. Let us make man in our own image after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the cattle of the field. What says here? Dominion over the cattle of the field. Whatever the cattle was there, all the animals, cattle, the dominion he had. Whatever you come means come, you go means go. It will listen the person. So the now if you see here, the if you notice the in creation, the first thing that was created, of course, was light. You come on down through the creation, the last thing was created was what? A man and woman. The first he created the light. First thing, first day only. Then after the sixth day, he created the last thing was created was what? A man and woman. Last only he made it. Before first he did not make. But he make it last one. Was made after man. All right. The last thing that was created of God, God creation, his mankind. Amen. What says here? That was created of God's creation. God creation, he created own like his likeness and whose own his image. And but when God made his first man, if you notice, he made him in the likeness of himself. Likeness means God is a spirit. You can see in the John chapter also, John chapter 4:24 also we can see. So here says, but here John chapter 4 chapter you read this, Jesus speaking to the woman in the, if you like to turn it, having much time, just didn't write them right down, just have to make by memory, and you look them up now. If I can find right cue, now let's begin about 4th chapter and 14th verse. Believe we have get a little above now, find out what I want you to see here. Maybe I can find it on down here. So what says 23rd and 24th verse? All right. Ye worship and ye know not what we know what we worship. For salvation is of the Jews, right? But the hour cometh, and now is that true worshipper, Jew or Gentile, shall worship the Father, the Spirit, and the truth. Amen. For the Father seeketh such to worship him. Now the next verse is here. I want, God is a spirit. And they that worship him must worship him in spirit and truth. Amen. Here clearly says, when we we are in the spirit. Now word of God says, means when God created a man in his own image, means the spirit. If we don't worship in spirit and truth, if we normally just by the letters or the telling somebody to worship the Lord, it is not the worshiping. It is the, you have to worship spirit and truth.
Yes.
It only, it can be connected with the word of God.
That's right.
It is always, if you are just only, creed only if you do, you will not get it the right spirit.
That's right.
You cannot get the right spirit and right mind of the Christ.
Amen.
Because without the right mind Christ, because our mind should be in Christ, then only we get the spirit of God.
That's right.
Here God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and truth.
Amen.
If you are not worshiping in spirit truth, we are coming and we are going, it is simply the time pass only. But when we come to the worship place, we have, if our side beside anybody is there, we should not look. Whatever the spirit, God's spirit in you, that it is making you the worshiping. It will make you real worship. Because you want to worship, you want to say Amen, you want to pray, you want to praise the Lord. It is by the Spirit only it should come.
Right.
Not only the brother telling you tell Amen. No, it should come by the Spirit only.
That's right.
Not telling you say Amen. No. But when you have the God Spirit, truth if you have, then only you can say that is no hindrance there will be.
That's right.
You will the inspiration, it will come your by own.
Amen.
Because the Holy Spirit says, you say it will come your mouth also.
That's right.
Amen. Like this. So here if God created man in his own image and his own likeness, what kind of a man did create it? What kind of a man did he create? A spirit man.
That's right.
And if you will notice, after he had made all the creation and created spirit man, when the spirit man he had completely God's he cannot hide anything.
That's right.
From him, because unfolded things he can reveal us.
That's true.
When God make us spirit man, he will not hide anything.
That's right.
He will unfold everything.
Amen.
Whatever the secret things will be there, he will unfold us.
That's right.
So here says, and close, reading this this now to the one that asked the question, we will find it this: God gave dominion of the cattle and the fish and everything of the man. But in his making up there, he made man his own image to lead the cattle, lead the beast of the field, just like the Holy Spirit leads the believers today. See, how leads means here says the cattle, God make a man the says fish, dominion of the cattle and the fishes and everything to the man. But in his making up there, he made man his own image to lead the cattle.
That's right.
Lead the cattle. So cattle will listen and cattle will follow what man says.
That's right.
So here says, lead the beast of the filled, just like the Holy Spirit leads the believers today, see now. So, if we don't have the Holy Spirit, we cannot lead the church.
That's right.
We cannot guide the church. We cannot feed the church.
That's right.
So, because everyone has the Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit makes understanding. Man cannot make understanding that we are praying for the pastor because he will feed the flock, because when we pray to him, pray to all the ministers, then only Holy Spirit makes us the understanding of the unfolding things. Unfolding things he will make us to understand, because we are the bride of Christ. We are the bride of Christ. Christ is he is the bridegroom for us.
Amen.
So whatever he knows the secret things, unfolded things he knows, whatever future, whatever present tense, whatever the future tense, whatever the past tense, he knows.
Amen.
But we don't know the future tense. So he will make unfolding things, everything.
Right.
When we become a spirit man, that's why if you are not born in a spirit, you will not get it.
Right.
When you are born again in the spirit, all the understanding you will get it.
Amen.
So that's why here says the. In other words, Adam, the first man in the lower creation of God. Adam, when God created, he is the lower creation of God. Before he created all the animals and all the fish and all, he created. At the last moment, he created the man and woman. So here says creation of God. The first creation was God himself. Then out of God came the Logos. The Logos came out, which was the Son of God. So which was the Son of God. Then out of the Logos, which was the Word. In the John chapter 1 chapter says, in the beginning was the Word. Word was with God, and Word was God. So here says the Son of God, then out of the Logos, it come, which was the Word. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God, Word was with God, and the Word was God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelling among us.
Amen.
See, that same Spirit, the Logos, the Son of God, he came in our midst and he manifested, he was made flesh and dwelled among us.
Amen.
See, out of the Logos came forth the man. From the Logos, the Logos came out of that. So, came from the man. See here. Now we can see the example of Lazarus. Lazarus, when the Lazarus, he died, and after 3 days, 4 days, he was lying over in the graveyard.
Yes.
So maybe after 4 days it was smelling also.
That's right.
But still God is telling, here Jesus is telling, after he got all his creation made, he said, let us, plural, make man in our plural own image. Now if God unseen, if the Logos was in the form, just mystically speaking drama, in the form of a halo, then it's supernatural. Then he had make a man in his own image. John chapter 4 says the God is a spirit. And here says, and he governed the beast like the Holy Spirit, leads the church today. But there was no man to till the soil. There was no man to till the ground, soil. So here, then he put man in the image of man on earth. Man in the image of the on the earth, created him out of the dust of the earth. See, he, because before he was spirit man, when the Jesus Christ came into the during the time of Jesus Christ, when he dead Lazarus body, he spoken that word. Just he spoken the word and life came. That dominion power, when we completely are in the spirit, that Jesus Christ told us, you will make a miracle more than me. When it will be become, when we be in the spirit, the spirit leads us, that dominion power it will come. Same dominion power, how it will come when we born in the spirit and you will become a matured in the spirit, then the creation, you whatever you say before the foundation of the world, he told that dominion power, the creation, it will create in our body. Amen. So that power, it will come. So here says prophet, and he governed the beast like the Holy Spirit leads the church today, but there was no man to till the soil. Then he put in the image of man on the earth, create him out of the dust and the earth. Here says now, question number 2 and 3. God made you from Adam's rib. Genesis chapter 2:18. Did God created man and woman when make Adam and Eve? Here that there is a question. As you will see here, 2:18 to 21, Genesis chapter 2:18 to 21. Notice, and the Lord God said, it is not good that man should be alone. I will make him an helpmate for him. Because here says word of God, God said, it is not good to that man should be alone. Because every creature he created, every animal, every fish, there is a female and male and female. So here Adam was alone. God thought he should not be alone.
That's right.
So God here, he was thinking to, I will make him an helpmate for him. And out of the ground of the ground, the Lord formed every beast and so forth. Now God made Eve from Adam's side. The woman has no one more rib today. See here, God made you from Adam's side. The woman has one more rib today. In the anatomy, the make up then man does, because a rib was taken from Adam's body. Adam had already been made and was living and was lonesome, and then God said, it is not good that man should live alone.
Oh my.
Take little further. Okay. Here says, now God made you from Adam's side. The woman has one more rib today. So this, but now God making you and Adam and you at the same time, the only thing he made was the supernatural, the spirit. Adam and the spirit Eve, the man and woman. First he made the spirit supernatural. He made the supernatural. The spirit Adam and the spirit Eve. He put the spirit and the then when he made put Adam in her, it is good. God's picture unfolding all the time. God's picture all the time, he unfolding time, that time, unfolding all the time. Everything like this, it is just coming right down, just unfolding right out, coming out through the millennium over yonder and right on into eternity. Just God's picture, just unfolding, God's unfolding himself. Because God's unfolding, and because he cannot reveal whatever the, because the here says, here God manifested himself in Christ Jesus. God manifested himself in Christ Jesus. It showed what he was. What was Jesus? A man of sorrow, acquainted with grief, loving to the prostitute. Where are the accusers? When Jesus Christ, during the time of Jesus Christ, the prostitute woman came and he said, if any man not mistaken, he make sin, only that people only can throw the stone. But there was nobody was there, the good person. There was no, there was no good people to throw the stone. But Jesus Christ here says, where are thy accusers? Who accuses here? I have none, Lord, neither do I accuse you. Go sin no more.
Amen.
Because there was no good people there. There was no good people were there. So only the Jesus Christ, he can say, the what says here? Go sin no more.
Amen.
The authority the Jesus Christ has, the Spirit, the same God, he has the authority to pardon the sin.
That's right.
So that's why this prostitute woman can boldly, and she completely, she God, Jesus Christ said here, go sin no more, said, because who has no sin, he only can say the go and sin no more.
That's right.
So here says go, here now there is an but now where did Cain get this wife? Now third question is here. The third question. Now here's the another thing. Did Cain go to the first creation of man and woman for his wife? Now there is an awful tickish questions. Now listen real close. Now you seen people put in the paper, where did Cain get his wife? Oh, I used to save it. Just go further. Yeah. And I never thought there was a burning hell for about your years after my conversation. I had to see it in the scripture. If I don't know, I won't say nothing about its sea. But now, where did Cain get his wife? Now, that's the analysis of questions. Cain got his wife to the creation of man and woman for his wife. See, now one of the first, I got here. Well, I stood here just about 2 months old in the gospel. I said, don't want to differ with you, man, because I am not student. I just saved, but I said, it'd be 1 minute. Now notice, let me tell you, but here what happened, the colored race of the nothing to do with this Cain. I want to watch. They said that he wants to land of Nod. Now Cain was in Eden, and Eden, the garden of Eden, laid east of Eden. Is that right? The garden of Eden was east in Eden. The east side of Eden and the cherubim was placed, and the tree of life was the east gate of the garden. And that's where I think Cain and Abel made their sacrifice, and if that would be so, I said, no sir, the colored race never come from there. No sir, the colored race is of the same tree that were of, and every human being the same one. There's no difference exactly. We are just all one, maybe yellow and the other one brown, the other one black, and the other one white, and the other one pale, and the other one red, and the other, and just like that. But you are all from that same tree. That's just the physically part of out of her. That's right. You are a human being, just same created her by God. And now notice here, not long ago, standing over here, and some doctors, Luis Villa, I was talking about in Africa, how those poor people, the cannibal type especially, how they had a woman that took a little baby, had found a little baby, and she had beat it like that and tied up and to bush and let it rot for a few days, you know, till it become contaminated before this eat, you know, anything like that. They let it rot little while, get soft. Don't think that too much about cannibals in England. They do same thing. They kill peasant and hang them the tree. So once the father will drop out of them, they eat them, that mother race of the Anglo-Saxon people, and in England. That's right. I go further because it will take time. Here. I want to watch. They said he went to the land of Nod. Now Cain was a Eden. Yeah, I will take front. Did you notice Jesus will come for east? The light rises from the east. Everything coming, civilization started the east and traveling west until revolves around the catches itself again. We are the western hemisphere, that's the eastern. The eastern is the oldest civilization. China's oldest civilization known of by historian in the world today, east. How we could dwell on those questions of hours of one but with wouldn't just the other, but notice how many would like to know. We believe Cain were and who Cain's wife was. Let's see. All right, I will tell you what Cain done, and it's the only sensible answer you can figure. Cain married his own sister. He had to, for there was only one female on the earth. Then the Bible only gives record of the three being born, harm, shame, or not. I beg your pardon. Was Cain, Abel, and Seth? But if there wasn't any, the Bible seldom records a girl's birth. You know it that. Now I am sure picking on the woman tonight, but look, the word worship woman, but woman was the devil's instrument in the beginning. And sister Sarah, don't be nervous because here word of God, here prophet is telling clearly. The world worship woman, but woman was the devil's instrument in the beginning. And an unjust one today is the best instrument he's got. She will send more preacher to hell than all the bootleg joints there is in the world. Let a little flapper with a cigarette in the corner of her mouth and her hair cut cute up like that, and great big long eyelashes and that blink up and down, brother, a little kind of nick looking physics on her watch, what she will do. Now here the prophet is telling. Now woman means here the, because they bob cut, because woman take from the man only, but man they don't want makeup and all, but woman's makeup because look pretty. So the here says here now become woman's preacher also. See, it is goes woman's dominion, like, you know. Now here says, now I am sure picking on the woman tonight, but here, preacher, you better cover yourself up with the blood of Jesus Christ. That's right. Now don't tell me you are man. I've seen too much of it. Now watch here. The best thing to do, keep your mind centered on Jesus Christ and let your thoughts be pure. Yes. Because our thought, it will not be pure It is not in the Christ Jesus. Today morning also we heard what he says, if you are looking woman, just you look lustily, thinking also you look her also, you make a you commit sin. It is very big thing is that one. So we if we, before not like that, if you only the make a adultery, then you get punishment. But when Jesus Christ came, the more than that this thing, more than that power means if you look her the other thought, if you think that, you make adultery. So it is too hard. Here says, but we are preacher, we have to be in the Holy Spirit only. Without the Holy Spirit guide, without the Holy Spirit in our heart, without the anointing, we cannot stand over here. Because we are serving to God, we should not be, one wrinkle should be in our heart. Should not be. So we can serve God through the Holy Spirit. So here says, like Paul said, over in there said, it's we know that we have the power to lead the sister. I have power to do it, but said, I won't do it. Because in our carnal mind, we cannot control the woman. The nature of the body we cannot control. Only can control the with the Holy Spirit only. Amen. Otherwise we will not control ourselves. Because this body, till the carnal mind we have, we cannot control our body. Because many, now if we go to see in the Roman Catholic Church, their priests, they cannot marry, because after that, if they cannot marry, means they should be controlled. Without the Holy Spirit, you cannot control yourself. You have to be married, because the God, Word of God says, Lord, because man should not be alone. Man should not be alone. That's why God gave him helpmate. So now this Roman Catholic Church, they completely out of the Word of God, because they are the priest, they are telling, but they are not following the Word of God. They cannot marry the priest, but with the Holy Spirit, the Paul is telling here, see. Like Paul said, over in there said, we know that we have the power to lead the sister. I have to power to do it, but said, I won't do it. See, he wouldn't do it, he said. We cannot do it, because the carnal mind, we cannot tolerate. We cannot control our body. So we will make a mistake. We will make adultery. We will make sin. So that's why here Paul says here, said, should not do it. I know that the ministry should lead by there, not muzzle the ox that tread out the corn. You know the sometimes things cause we are a preacher, not you and I, don't say brother. But preachers thinks because they are preachers that they are somebody bigger than one of the laity member of the church. You are no bigger and you are no more sight of God than the drunkard that was converted an hour ago. Here says we morning also we heard. Only the pastors, teachers, only they want the car. If they are carnal mind, they want the position. They want, I am a big preacher, you have to give respect for me. That's the thinking of my man's thinking. The preachers, now worldly preachers, they are thinking, people are come to me and they have to worship me like, but there is no glory to God. We are giving honor to man, but we have to give honor to God.
Amen.
Man only what we call vessels only.
That's right.
So we respect each other. But honor to God only we have to give honor.
Amen.
But we are the vessels. We are nothing. We are like a dust only.
That's right.
But here many people, they are the preacher means they become a big, everybody should come to me and everybody should come to my feet like this. Not like that. Because we are all one brother and sister. We are looking for the rapture. So when God unfolding things to reveal in his own bride only.
Amen.
He will not reveal other person.
That's right.
He will reveal only his people, his bride only he will reveal.
Amen.
So here says Paul, that's one thing the Reformation ever purged was their things. I know. Sign my name, Reverend. That's exactly. That's the just a custom that of the today. But it shouldn't be done, Reverend, and Bishop, and doctors, and all those things are man-made titles. Now we can say, in India, Reverend means it is the big position. Somebody told you pay the money and your pastor's certificate is there. No, we can make it you reverend. I said I don't want reverend position because reverend it is only the Lord Jesus Christ only. Because we have to honor to him. Reverend it is not for the man. Here titles we can make it. Here they can make it reverend. They can make it big titles. Here says titles. And their nonsense. In the Bible, they were Peter, James, Paul, John, and all the rest of them. Paul said, now here, I know, preach the gospel, that's my duty. I am a preacher, he is a preacher, Brother Neville a preacher, but our duty is to be preacher.
Yes.
Our duty only preaching. Whatever the God gives, only we can give to the flock. Only give it to the flock only. Because whatever the God's with the Spirit, Holy Spirit, whatever the message give, because I was studying all the COD, little bit, I cannot, because if we dig more and more also, it cannot be maybe one message, maybe 1 week whole, more than 1 week also. But it is 2-3 days I am studying, but I get little only in that. But because the COD, it is more deeper and deep if we go, more if we study that also, it cannot be because in our mind, because I am not a teacher, if you real God's gift, teacher's gift is there, because God give the knowledge, whatever the capable of our mind, that much only we can give that much. More than we can yet cannot give, because if we more go deep, our mind completely, it is digging, it is sometime after 1 hour, 2 hours, we have to drink a tea. Completely, because it is not easy. Here standing, it is not easy to stand here. It is through the Holy Spirit only it will guide us. Because in our own mind, In our own thinking, we cannot study. Only the Holy Spirit only can give the message.
Amen.
Without our own mind, our own thinking, we cannot give. Because 1 hour, 2 hour, we can sit in this message. It is not enough. Only 5 minutes only I can give this message like this. 2-3 hours if I sit also. If we dig and dig and dig, it will take more hour. It is not easy. Brother Dandy, is really it is... It will take time to stand behind the pulpit. It is not easy.
That's right.
Through the Holy Spirit only we have to understand, and those who are listening to accept the word of God also.
Amen.
Not only preaching, the both the side to understand.
Yes.
If you are not understanding me, whatever the word of God comes here, if we give. Only for the purpose I give, it is not benefit for you.
That's right.
So we have to go through it, and we can give. Brother Dandy here can only basically things he can give. Whatever the God gives him and whatever God gives us, that much only we can give, not more than that. Once we give also, that you, the word of God should remain in your heart.
Yes. Amen.
Otherwise, whole 100-page message gives also, it won't remain. It will become time pass, like, you know.
That's right.
If we give one word, it should be remain in our heart.
Amen.
The word of God remain, then it will manifested in our life.
That's right.
Otherwise, it will not just only come and hear and today we enjoy the message, we enjoyed. No, it should be go into our heart.
Amen.
And it will make you manifested, and it will make you the life of Jesus.
Right.
The life of Jesus should in our heart.
Amen.
The sacrifice. The Jesus Christ had that sacrifice life, same should have his bride also.
Amen.
The sacrifice life. But in this world, the Satan brings so many things in our life, so many tests it will come, so many sacrifice comes, the patience should be in our heart.
Amen.
Without the patience, the morning said, One slap give, word of God says, you show another face also. It is very difficult to give that in this world. That's why the agape love, you have that agape love, you will pray for each other.
Amen.
Whenever man make a mistake, we will pray for him. And man always make mistake.
That's right.
Man always make minute he will make a mistake.
Yes,
but the thing like Stephen, how more people he thrown also, then also his word forgive them. They don't know anything.
That's right.
So that when it will come. The love of God go inside, the Holy Spirit makes the love.
Amen.
See, that love, it should be, when anybody goes wrong, we pity, we feel, you feel pity.
Yes, that's right.
Not, he's doing always like this only. But we have, when the love of God comes, the love of God makes you the humble. Then we will pray.
Amen.
If we beat also for us, we will pray for him. That
Amen.
God will give the patience. You cannot, carnal mind, you cannot bear.
Amen.
If you have carnal mind, you cannot bear. Supernatural mind, you can have that character. Otherwise, you cannot have that character. So here says, here, the Well, that's the we are supposed to be, but let me do something. Paul said, that's beyond that. Now, I got a right to take up money, Paul said, but I am going to make tents just to show you I can sacrifice. He said, it's honorable. Marriage is honorable among all. The bed undefiled, it's good for a man to be married. Man should be, because Paul is telling, if you cannot control yourself, you better to marry. Otherwise, if you cannot control yourself, you marry. Otherwise, you want to be like a saint, you have to control. But it will not, carnal mind people cannot control the body. So that's why the Holy Spirit needed. That's why Paul is telling, better the man and woman, they cannot control, let them marry. Here says, see, honorable marriage is honorable among all. The beds undefiled, it's good for a man to be married. He said, I got a right to be married. Now, I couldn't marry. I got a legal right to be married, but I just won't get married. I want to do another sacrifice to the Lord. See, sacrifice means Paul sacrificed it. Because why? Because for the Lord. Because Paul was killing the Christian people. So he want to, because of the Lord, he want to sacrifice his life, not to marry. So he can control through the Holy Spirit, not carnal mind he cannot control. So that's why he has said, I want to do another sacrifice to the Lord. See, then he said, every man knows his calling. Let him do as for the word of God sake. Some people now, he cannot get the merit. So that's why he can control. So here says, good to be married. He said, I got a right to be married. Now I could be married. I got a legal right to be married. But I just won't get married. I want to do another sacrifice to the Lord. See, then he said, every man knows his calling. Everybody knows our calling. When we come in the ministry, and how we can minister to the Lord, we know our calling.
That's right.
I can say, I am not the teachers, because my calling is not the teachers. I am not capable of the teachers, but I can preach. I can give the word of God. I can go here and there. I can do the Lord's work, and those who are calling for prayer, I can go and pray. The calling I know. So here Paul is also telling, every man knows his calling. Let him do as some knows for the word of God's sake. Because we can control for the sake of the word of God. So just take prayer. We want to do something beyond our duty, and if you really born again of the Spirit of God and say, that's my duty to go to church, I guess I will have to go. Oh my, well, I want to do more than that. I want to win some soul for Christ. I want to do something. I want to visit the sick or do something for him. It's my duty. Preach funerals. It's my duty. just take friend. It's my duty to preach the gospel. It's my duty to pray for the sick. Let me do something else. Let me get out and do something where God will honor me by it. So whatever the calling is, God given the calling, that only we can do, not more than that. Because I cannot be a pastor, I cannot be a prophet, I cannot be an evangelist. Because whatever the God has given the calling, that only we can do. Because God called, because we are all in the body of Christ, we are all part. So God given the everyone one part he has given in the body of Christ. We have to do it honestly and honorably. We have to do it because we are serving all of our brethren. We are serving to God, not Brother Dandy or not Brother Kumar, Brother Nelson or not anyone. We are all serving to God. Amen. So we are preparing to go to the rapture. So here no one should be here in this world. After that the tribulation comes. That prophet also is telling, nobody wants the tribulation. Before that we have now time to prepare ourselves. Whatever God given the calling, we have to do honestly and honorably. We have to do. And here says, it's my, whatever the duty has given to everyone, we have to do it, because we have to, should not be become a laziness. We cannot be sleep, because there is now no time. No time there is now, because the world now, worldly also people, they are all now afraid. Because why? This corona come now in the Bible, there is no name in the Bible, that much sickness comes. So the God given the time to do our duty, because to preach the gospel is my duty. To pray for the sick, it is my duty. Let me do something else. Let me get out and something where God will honor me by it. Yeah. Only the God should honor and God should be appreciate in our duty. Whatever the duty has given for us, it is we have to be do honorably and humbly, because we are not doing for men. We are doing for God. Amen. So whatever the duty has given, each and every small duty also, no problem. Honorably and respectfully we will do. Really God will appreciate, and each and everyone, because we are mistaken people. We are always mistaken. So anybody mistaken also, we pity on him. When it will pity comes, God, if you have God's love, the Holy Spirit, the agape love you have that character. Amen. So we need that character, and let God use everyone, and that is my prayer, and God bless you all. Amen. And I will hand over to Brother Andrew.
Hallelujah. So, just to let everybody understand that the last meeting that we had with the Board of Deacons, we will try to open up the COD one at a time. COD is the conduct, order, and doctrine that was given to us by Brother Branham. And every Friday afternoon, whenever there's a service, all the deacons who will be standing behind this pulpit will try to open up parts of those. So you will either you go for one question, or like today we have three questions that we have seen. That will be now part of every Friday afternoon service. So we have three questions today. First question is about, remember, what's the difference between Genesis 1:26 against Genesis 2:7? Remember, there is the creation and there is the forming. And we know that the creation is about the creation of the spirit man, and the forming is about the forming of the flesh. So that is the difference between the two. And the spirit man, then Brother Branham went back to Genesis, to John 1, remember? He says that John 1:18, that no man has seen God. And then in John 1, he says that the Son came out from the bosom of the Father, remember? So there's a light that came out from the bosom of the Father. So that's the Son that was given, and that's the Christ that we know. So that invisible God that we can see as the fountain of the seven spirits, that same fountain that no one has seen went into that body, that is spiritual body, which he called Christ and which he called Son. Are you following us? So when he say that, let us make man in our image, which is Genesis 1:26, the image of man, or the image of God, was a spirit man, a spirit God, as what John 4:24 said, that let us worship God in spirit and in truth. And so the image of God that is a spirit, and is the same spirit man that was created. So the first creation that will happen is a spirit man, which even before we have the forming of the flesh, it is the creation that happened, which is the spirit man, and then forming of the flesh came in. That is the first question. The second question, what is the difference between the man and the woman that was created against the Eve, Adam and Eve that were created? Remember, it's almost the same thing. So was Adam and Eve created as Adam and Eve against the man and the woman that was in Genesis 1:26? So it's almost the same question. It's almost the same answer. And Brother Branham says that we have an extra, the woman have an extra rib. And I don't know, but today, that in the time, we understand and we believe that God has taken that extra rib from Adam, and it was given to the woman. But even today in our medical, if you're going to look at the medical, it's not always that there's always an extra rib for the man. But the regular ribs that each and every person has is 12 sets of rib, 12 pairs of rib, and that's standard. So in some occasions, you're going to find that there are 13 ribs. If I'm not mistaken, correct me if I'm wrong, Brother Chris. And at sometimes you're going to find that there are 11. So sometimes, but not every time, but most of the time, it's an 12 pairs for both man and woman that is existing. So we're not saying that it's not true that it happened, but it happened. It's because it's written in the scripture. And we believe that there's 11, one rib was taken out of Adam. We didn't, the scripture is not telling us that everybody will be having 11 ribs. Right? The scripture didn't tell us that. But the scripture told us that Eve was taken out of Adam, out of the rib of Adam. So when we believe in that. And the third question that we got is about the wife, the husband of the wife of Cain. Remember that no one, no other people were there, and the only people that was in there was Adam and Eve. And open up Genesis chapter 5, sister, please. You're gonna find that there are daughters of Adam. So in Genesis chapter 5, though it's not mentioned as a name, but the daughters, Adam has sons. Aside from Seth and Cain, and Seth and Abel, there are also other daughters. Male and female created, he them and blessed them and called their name Adam in the day when they were created. And Adam lived 130 years and begat a son in his own likeness after his image. Now Adam's image became the image of the flesh. So that's why when Seth came up, it's already in the image of the flesh. And the days of Adam, after he had begotten Seth, were 800 years, and he begat sons and daughters. So if you're going to notice in here, in this scripture, you're going to find that there are daughters that came out of Adam, but no one knows the name.
That's right.
So when Brother Branham says that no one is existing except Cain's wife was his sister, it means his sister in Eve. It's because that there are no other source of human being that time except he has to go back to one of the daughters of Adam. So that the husband or the wife of Cain, as the third question, is the daughter of Adam. You're going to find it in the scripture. So that's all the questions that we have. We will be continuing this next week. Let us all stand. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's sing My Hope is in the Lord. We don't have any other hope but God Himself. I stand in awe within the presence of the Lord, in whom the wisdom of the ages lies, for whom the raging of the sea subsides, the living sacrifice, the only source of life. His tender mercies come with every rising sun to meet the sinner in his brokenness, to offer healing and forgiveness. And those who trust in him will find their hearts at rest. My hope is in the Lord from this time on and nevermore. My hope is in the Lord forevermore. I stand in awe within the presence of the Lord, in whom the wisdom of the ages lies, for whom the raging of the sea subsides, the living sacrifice, the only source of life. His tender mercies come with every rising sun to meet the sinner in his brokenness, to offer healing and forgiveness. And those who trust in him will find their hearts at rest. My hope is in the Lord from this time on and evermore. My hope is in the Lord forevermore. Let's sing it one more time. Oh, my hope is in the Lord from this time on and evermore. My hope is in the Lord forevermore. Hallelujah, 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 Lord. Let us thank God. And in closing, may I call on Brother Rohit to. Hallelujah. So let's call Brother Let's call Brother Henry.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Lord, salamat po, Panginoon, sa hapong ito, Panginoon, sa pagtatapos ng aming gawain, Panginoon.
Amen.
Maraming maraming pong salamat, Panginoon, sa kapatid niyo pong ginamit na si Brother Kumar, Panginoon. Pagpalayan niyo po siya, Panginoon, at pati na po, Panginoon, ang kanyang pamilya, Panginoon. Maraming salamat, Panginoon, sa mga salita niyong binigay niyo sa aming mga puso, Panginoon. Tunay nga, Panginoon, na pagpapala, Panginoon, sa buong isang linggo, Panginoon, ng aming buhay, Panginoon. Nawa, Panginoon, ay patuloy niyo po kaming ingatan, Panginoon. At pati na rin po, Panginoon, ang aming mga pamilya, Panginoon, na nasa Pilipinas, Ama. Ingatan niyo po sila, Panginoon, na katulad po ng pag-iingat niyo sa amin, Panginoon. Salamat din po, Panginoon, sa lahat, Panginoon, na mga biyay at pagpapalang patuloy niyo pong pinagkakaloob sa amin, Panginoon. At dalangin ko rin po, Panginoon, ang aming mga kapatid na sa ngayon, Panginoon, ay wala rito, Panginoon. Nawa, Panginoon, kayo po, Panginoon, ang siyang umaliw sa kanila, Panginoon. Habang sila po, Panginoon, ay hindi po namin kapiling, Panginoon, sa aming gawain ito, Panginoon. Dalangin ko po, Ama, na nawa, Panginoon, ang aming natanggap na biyaya, Panginoon, ngayong hapon, Panginoon, sa buong maghapong ito, Panginoon, ay nakamit po rin nila, Panginoon, at maipamuhay po nila, Panginoon, sa darating na buong isang linggo, Panginoon. Maraming marami pong salamat, Panginoon, at patuloy niyo po kaming bigyan ng kalakasan, Panginoon, talino, Panginoon, na nagmumula sa inyo, Panginoon, at salamat, Panginoon, sa thank you, O Lord, for your love of God, for the love of God that you give in our heart, Lord. It's true, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for all the trials, Lord, for all the sorrows, Lord, and joy and gladness that you put in our heart, O Lord. Thank you very much, Lord. I will give you all the honor and praises in the name of our Lord mighty Jesus. Amen and amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Our service has ended this afternoon. May God bless you all. From this time on.